morning, children. I am Gizmo. I'm happy to be here today. Are you excited to be here today? I have friends called Joy and Chris. They are not here with me today, but we are going to worship God together, and we are going to learn something from the Bible that talks about God. Let's celebrate today together.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through Him, and without Him, nothing was made that was made.
What can't you do?
What can't you do, Jesus? Gizmo from Superbook. We appreciate you for being with us today. And thank you so much, worship team, for leading us well and for prayer. We really appreciate you. Good morning, boys and girls. Good morning, guys. It's good to see all of you today and to have you with us. Thank you so much for joining us for today's lesson. We really appreciate those who are listening to us, those who are watching us on Hope TV and also on social media pages on Facebook, Church Sitam Church Online, and also Hope Media Facebook pages. We really appreciate you. You are most welcome for our lesson today. My name is Njeri Mwaura. I'm a pastor from Sitam Gong, and I am joined by
Tugi Kafura. I am from Sitam Gong. Welcome to this lesson.
And
Kiama Kimani from Sitam Gong, and welcome to our lesson today.
Thank you so much. Guys, were you with us last week? Were you there for our last lesson? What was the lesson that we learned? Do you remember? Do you remember our memory verse? And I also hope you are doing your work on the journal, the work that we give every day, Monday to Friday. I hope you are doing it. Kindly do it and send us something to tell us that you are following and that you are doing that work with us. What was our lesson last week, Tugi?
Jesus has power over death.
Jesus has power over death. That was the story of?
Lazarus.
Lazarus. Lazarus was dead, and Lazarus was raised from the dead by Jesus, and that is what we learned. We also learned a memory verse. Do you remember? What was it?
John chapter 11, verse 25 to 26. Mm-hmm. It says, Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me will never die. He will live even though he die. And whoever lives believing with me will never die. Do you believe this?
Thank you. That was our memory verse. John chapter 11, verse 25 and 26. Now, today's lesson, I'm going to ask a question to Tugi. Have you ever tried to do something that has been so hard that you couldn't do?
Yes.
What was it?
Making ugali.
Making ugali? Guys, do you know how to make ugali? Do you know how hard that can be? So were you able to make it?
Yes.
With whose help?
My father's help.
Your dad's help?
Yes.
Wow. Thank you, Baba Tugi, for helping Tugi make ugali. Have you ever tried anything that was so hard?
Yes.
What?
Dina Sudoku.
Sudoku. Wow. I don't know how to do Sudoku myself. I deal with letters. I would rather do a crossword. But have you ever tried something that, like that, that was so hard that you couldn't even figure out how it is done? Were you ever able to do it?
No.
No? Even up to now?
No.
Okay. Somebody needs to help Kiama to do Sudoku because it is hard for him. Boys and girls and guys who are watching us, our lesson today is that Jesus has power to do the impossible. Jesus has power to do the impossible. Write that on your notebook. And our Bible story comes from the book of John, chapter 21, verse 1 to 14. John, chapter 21, verse 1 to 14. Kindly get your Bibles. We want to read and hear what was happening. Tugi, will you lead for us the first 7 verses, and then Kiama will read the following 7 verses. Kindly lead with us. Pick your Bible as we continue. Let's read together.
After this, Jesus appeared to his disciples again. It was by the Sea of Galilee. Here is what happened. Simon Peter and Thomas, who was also called Didymus, were there together. Nathanael from Cana in Galilee and the sons of Zebedee were with them. So were the other two disciples. I am going out to fish, Simon Peter told them. They said, we'll go with you. So they went out and got into the boat. That night they didn't catch anything. Early in the morning, Jesus stood on the shore, but the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. He called out to them, friends, don't you have any fish? No, they answered. He said, throw your net on the right side of the boat. There you will find some fish. When they did, they could not pull the net into the boat. There were too many fish in it. Then the disciple Jesus loved said to Simon Peter, it is the Lord. As soon as Peter heard that, he put his coat on that he had earlier taken off. Then he jumped into the water.
The other disciples followed him in the boat, towing the net full of fish, for they were not far from the shore, about 100 yards. When they landed, they saw a fire burning coals. There was fish on it and some bread. Jesus said to them, bring some of the fish you have just caught. Simon Peter climbed aboard and dragged the net ashore. It was full of large fish, 153. But even with so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, come and have breakfast. None of the disciples dared ask him, who are you? They knew it was the Lord. Jesus came, took the bread and gave it to them, and did the same with the fish. This was now the third time Jesus appeared to the disciples after he was raised from the dead.
Thank you. Thank you so much for the reading. And thank you all who have read that story with us. What was happening in the story?
Some of the disciples were going fishing.
Some of the disciples were going fishing. Okay. And why were they going back to fishing?
Because they had no other activity after Jesus left them.
They had no other activity to do after Jesus had left. Remember, this story is happening after the resurrection of Jesus. And when Jesus was crucified, the disciples went their way. And now we see in this chapter that they are going back to their career, the work that they were doing. They were going back to fish. But Jesus, after resurrection, comes to look for them. And he finds them. And when he finds them, what did he tell them to do?
Tell them to cast their nets onto the right side.
Yes. This is because why they were told to cast their net on the right side is because they had toiled the whole night. How many fish did they catch at night?
None.
They didn't catch any fish. And that was very frustrating. And that can be very frustrating. Like Tugi here trying to make ugali and is unable to do, or Aikiama trying to do the Sudoku, or like something maybe you are trying to do, you who is listening to us and watching us, and you are not able to do it. You don't know how to get results out of what you are doing. The disciples had toiled the whole night trying to catch fish. Have you ever gone fishing?
No.
Even once?
Not even once.
Maybe you've tried?
No.
No? Wow. I've also never tried fishing. These ones were people who had done fishing all their life. They knew how to fish. They knew how to do their nets. They knew when to fish. And that is why they had gone out in the night. Because at night is when I hear fish are caught. That's when they are coming up and they can easily be caught. And that's why they went at night. But unfortunately, that night they never caught anything. So they were very frustrated. And they were feeling tired. And in the morning, Jesus arrives. And then Jesus tells them, throw your net on the right side of the lake. If it were you, what would you have done?
I would have told him, we've been fishing all night and we've not even caught one. And now you're coming to tell us cast our net on the right side.
You would be trying to argue with him and saying, yes, you've been here the whole night, you've done this for many years and we didn't catch anything. Now, why are you telling us? Is that what they did?
No.
No.
No. What did they do?
They obeyed as Jesus had said.
They obeyed what Jesus had said. And they threw their net. And what happened?
They caught lots of fish.
They caught lots and lots and lots of fish because they heard and they obeyed. Maybe you are there listening to us. Do you obey the word of God? If Jesus has told you something, like he has told us in the Bible, if we read his word and he says that we do not fear, are you there afraid and fearing what will happen to you or what will not happen? Are you there when Jesus has said that he is our healer? Are you there and you are unaware and you don't believe that Jesus can heal? What is it that is troubling you and you don't know what to do? What Jesus has said, if we listen, we believe it, and we obey what he tells us to do, Jesus is able to help us. And Jesus is able to come through for us. Is that so, Tugi?
Yes.
Yes. Maybe you are, did you ask your father to help you make ugali?
Yes.
And he did.
Yes.
And he came through and he helped you to learn. That is what Jesus does for us. When we tell him what our struggles are, he will come and help us because he is our God. So what do we learn from that story?
That no matter the circumstance, we should be obedient to God.
No matter our circumstance, we should be obedient to God. Tugi, what do we learn?
That Jesus is all powerful.
That Jesus is all powerful. If he can tell us to throw, tell the disciples to throw the net on the right side of the lake, and they are able to catch a lot of fish, that tells me that he is a powerful God and he can do it for us. So what are you going to do after this lesson?
I'm going to believe and obey God.
You are going to believe and obey God because he is a powerful God and he can do it for us. Kiama, what are you going to do?
No matter how it looks or no matter how it seems, mm-hmm, I am going to obey God and no one else.
We are going to obey God and no one else. Thank you for saying no one else. Because there are voices that we hear from the people we work around. Guys, maybe you have friends. And when you tell them you are going to pray or you are going to church, they tell you, no, it is not good. I don't know what. So you are not going to listen to any other person. The Bible says that when we ask in Jesus' name, he gives us. So you are going to believe that, not what your friend is saying. And that will be a good thing. And so we are going to believe that Jesus has power to do the impossible. And those things that we know, that they are hard and difficult for us. Even in this situation that we are in, we don't know what will happen or what is going to be. There's a disease that people are afraid of, but we remember that God has power to do the impossible. He can be able to carry us through whatever it is that we are going through. Before we come to the end of our lesson, and before even we pray, maybe you are there and there are things that are troubling you. There are things that are so hard that you are thinking about them and you are like, I don't know what to do here. Tugi, do you have anything like that?
Yes.
What is it?
The coronavirus and they want to open school.
The coronavirus and the opening of schools.
Yes.
Guys, if you are listening to us, just take a pen and in your notebook, write one or two things that you are so afraid of. Tugi is telling us she's afraid of how we go back to school and how the coronavirus and the infections are going. Write it down. Maybe it is not about the disease. Maybe there's something else you are going through in your own life or in your family. Write it down and we will take time to pray with you and to pray for all of us. Kiama, do you have anything like that?
No. Sometimes I find it difficult to convince some other people about Christ because some of them, Like they say they have everything, especially those rich people. They have all the money, they can buy everything, they can buy anything. So if you try to convince them, it's hard for them to listen.
Wow, that's a good one. You are trying to tell about Jesus, people about Jesus, your friends or your family. And they are bringing all these arguments because they have money. Kiama is saying because they are rich, they can do anything with money, they can buy anything, and they realize that they don't need Jesus. That can be difficult. But do you know what? Jesus enables us even to talk to that people and tell them that Jesus saves and that Jesus is good. So before we pray, because we are going to pray for those needs that you have written, we want to do our memory verse. Our memory verse for this lesson is from Mark chapter 9, verse 23. It is from
Mark chapter 9, verse 23.
Mm-hmm. It says, if you can,
Jesus said, everything is possible for him who believes.
Let's say that again. It's from
Mark chapter 9, verse 23. Mm-hmm. It says, if you can, Jesus said, everything is possible for him who believes.
Thank you so much. Kindly guys, you are listening to us, write it down. Mark chapter 9, verse 23. And you can memorize it and you can learn it in your heart, because it is good to remember that it is everything is possible to those who believe in our Lord and Savior. Maybe you are even there, you don't even know this Jesus as your Lord and Savior. We want to pray for you. Kindly say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I come to you recognizing that I am a sinner. Save me and forgive my sins and make me your child. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. If you have said that prayer, Jesus Christ has come into your heart. You can tell your parent or the people around you. You can tell your Sunday school teacher. You can tell your children ministry pastor in your church and ask them to help you to walk in the ways of the Lord. And now we are going to pray for all the needs that we have written down. Kindly believe with us that Jesus will be able to see you through. Kiama will lead us in that prayer. And then Tugi will pray for all those who have given their lives to Christ, even as we bring our lesson to the end this morning. Let's pray.
Let us pray. Our kind and everlasting Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the gift of life. Lord, we even pray for even those people who are watching us from even at home, Lord. Mm-hmm. Lord, we even pray for the needs that they have written. Lord, we know that you're all seen, Lord, and you can see the needs that they have written, Lord. We pray, Lord, that may you help them, and Lord, may you even come to them, and may you come to their point of need, Lord. May you help them to even face those needs, Lord, and may you provide for them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we pray for their families, Lord, and we pray that may you continue to protect us, for it is in Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen. Our dear Heavenly Father, we come before you this morning with thanksgiving in our hearts, thanking you for the gift of life. Lord, and those who have given their lives unto you, Lord, may you shower them with the blessings. And Lord, as we finish this lesson, Lord, protect us during the week. And Lord, those who have struggled in their life, Lord, provide for them. In Jesus' name we pray and believe.
Amen.
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 Amen. Thank you for praying together with us, and thank you for being with us today. And we know that the Lord will help you to remember that he is able to do everything that is impossible for us. And we want to pray that the Lord will give you a blessed week, keep you well, keep you safe, and that you meet again for the next lesson. Until that time, we are saying,
bye-bye. Bye.